When Renata Henry, mother of Jan Henry, spoke to News Force in November, she explained that the bullet that robbed her son of vision in his left eye in October 2020 was still lodged in his head. An appointment was scheduled to meet with Martinican health officials over the festive season to assess the situation and possibly remove the projectile. Now, the mother says, the French doctors grappled with the perilous procedure to remove the bullet.
We went up to Martinique on the 4th of December, but when we saw the doctor on the 11th, he told us that where the bullet is, he could remove it, but it's a risk going in there. So he'd rather leave it and let the child live his life. In the future, if it's going to affect him, he's going to go there. But for now, let him live his life.
The apple doesn't fall far from the tree, as the resolute mother describes her son's ongoing battle to settle back into a normal life. She says that fateful day on October 7th, 2020 has changed her family's life forever.
Jan is a strong little boy, like I always saying. He have his days, have days he'll be really frustrated, and have days he'll be good. But when you see Jan frustrated, everybody frustrated, because Jan patent on everybody. And to hear, like I was tempted to hear your son saying he had two eyes, now he have one, he have a bullet in his head, and especially saying, he said that never happened to my father, and right now I have a bullet in my head. My father never got shot, but right now I have a bullet in my head. And it's just not Jan alone, all my children have been affected. Because right now there is, I giving Jan all the attention, and like I give my other children less. So all the children feeling it too.
All hope is not lost for the Henry family, as the mother explains that one potential lifeline has been extended to her son for possible international medical intervention.
A man from Canada called me and told me like he want to help me for if he had to see maybe if Canada can take out the bullet, but he told me he was going to call me again, but I don't hear from him yet, so I'm just waiting. Oh, and I want to tell people, continue praying for Jan, because the prayer is working.
St. Lucia's ongoing battle with gun violence continues. A resounding call from family members of individuals lost or maimed as a result of gun violence echoes as they advocate for stiffer penalties for firearm offenses. Solange Alfred, HTS News Force.